found it quite instantaneous. I read the books, I read the script, and I fell in love with her bravery, with her passion, her commitment to her studies, and she's a beautiful person. And I remember I had a chemistry read with Matthew Good, and it was just about getting in the room and doing a workshop for an hour or two and putting the scenes down together. And we met each other, and the spark between us was there from the start. We both have three kids. We would be talking about the adventures in parenting, and we had a really good banter, and I felt so comfortable with him to explore these characters. And it felt magic from the start, and we kind of fell in love with the process of developing these characters together, and Deb had so beautifully written these well-rounded, interesting, complex individuals, and I just got to sink my teeth into her.
I mean, everybody's kind of hiding. I mean, everybody's kind of hiding in plain sight, but she also doesn't really want to use her powers and kind of pulls back from them a little bit. Why is that?
Diana wants to be normal. She doesn't want to stand out. She wants to focus on her studies. Her family, I don't want to give anything away. Can I say this? So her family was murdered by people who didn't like witches, or so she thinks. You might find out that it's a little bit of a different story later on, but I won't give anything away. And so she just wants to live a normal life. She wants to be an academic. She wants to pretend she doesn't have powers. She doesn't use her powers. In fact, they come out in all sorts of weird and wonderful ways when she least expects it. So she has no control over her powers. And I think she's just bothered by the idea of being a witch. She wants to deny her heritage, much to her aunt's dismay. They don't like that.
And what is the attraction about between the characters of Diana and Matthew? What draws them together? Because obviously there's a forbiddenness to them being together.
Yeah, I think that's my favorite part. It is forbidden love. It's a star-crossed lovers kind of story. And I just think, pardon the pun again, it's otherworldly. Their love is so intense, and it's a need. They have a need for each other. And it's there from the moment they lock eyes in the scene that we just saw. There aren't words to describe that kind of passionate connection. And she's a very smart woman. She knows that heading down into this place with Matthew, it's going to cause all sorts of chaos. It's going to be dangerous and scary, and it completely goes against everything she's ever thought or been taught in her life. But she can't help herself. The pull is just too strong.
But don't you think also she trusts him? Because that all these other creatures are all want the book that has presented itself to her. And ideally, she should align herself with one of the witches,
yeah.
But they don't feel trustworthy to her, do they? And Matthew, against all her better instincts as a vampire, he's the one she trusts.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, there's something about him that he wants to protect her, he wants to take care of her, he wants to ensure that she's using her magic in the right way, and he wants to teach her. And there's just this beautiful dynamic between the two of them. And so she jumps into this with him, and it's chaotic and beautiful and passionate and romantic and all those beautiful things. So,
and dangerous.
And very dangerous. Yeah, there's lots of people who we make unhappy.
Well, as we saw in the trailer, there is a point where she is at least using her power. She may not like it, but it's very explosive.
Yeah.
How is it to shoot those scenes, just for whether it's stunt work or just having to put your hands out there? How was that to shoot?
It was very specific, because I know when you have an audience that have read the novels, they probably have an idea of how the magic's going to look. And I remember asking Deborah, do you have any ideas of how she lights the candle? She can light things on fire. She has witch wind. She has witch water. She has all these incredible powers. And we had to create the way in which she showed these powers. How did it unravel from her body? And so it was actually quite technical in many ways. We had wire work. I know Owen Teal was on wires for one particular scene. I'm blowing away. We had to do a lot of stunts.
I'm often put on wires.
Yes.
But yeah, it was, you know, I think the Witch Wind scene we shot in 3 days in the Bond, and it was great. And luckily we had Deb at our fingertips, so I could call her or send her a message on Instagram quickly and say, how did you see this unraveling? How do you think, Diana, how does this power come out of her? Is it organic? Does she try very hard and then it comes out? And so she answered my question so beautifully.
But Diana does have some family, because there's Aunt Sarah,
yeah,
and Emily.
We have an interesting relationship, Sarah and I.
Well, before we talk about it, I think we can actually see a little bit of their relationship.